Imagine dropping a freestyle on a Clue, on a Clue tape, or being on a Clue show and dropping a freestyle. Now y'all got 95 South and LA Leakers and all these other people. Like, yeah. That's all the foundation. Like, you, if when Fabulous got made off of Clue tapes.
I said I'm heavy in the hood like the lotto and liquor. I'm just spitting my motto to niggas. Cause if I ever had a problem with any out of you niggas, I could send a shot at you niggas. They talking bars and I'm top tier, top shelf, pop shells, and niggas trying to stop my wealth. Niggas fronting like they got gear. Not here, been in the stores with bitches. The wares they not felt, but I'ma be the one to kill swag rap. Cause niggas say they in their bag, I took your bag, get your bag back. Professional songwriter, ass cap. This ain't no mad rap, this rad rap's about niggas who trap.
I don't even want to give, you know, DJ Clue his flowers. Got to give that man his, give that man a garden because,
a mausoleum, exactly.
You know, when we talk about like breaking records,
breaking
and
artists.
This is before like this whole artists. Digital era music. Yo, he I remember when I heard Biggie's Who Shot You?
Yeah, got to hear it.
And I heard it on DJ Clue. This was 1994, and I remember it was a local hustler in my neighborhood. He pulled up in the Acura Legend. And he was just banging that joint. And you hear DJ Clue, Biggie Smalls,
Illuminati,
you know what I'm saying? And yeah, DJ Clue's a guy who broke a lot of careers. He's
yeah,
really like a culture engineer.
Money. Yeah, I don't think he got the money that reflects that impact. You
yeah.
know what I'm saying? Like, he find this fee and like what people get paid now to academics and those guys, that's all Clue. That
yes,
all that
yeah.
was Clue. Imagine dropping a freestyle on a Clue. On a Clue tape or being on a Clue show and dropping a freestyle. Now y'all got 95 South and LA Leakers and all these other people. Like,
yeah.
that's all the foundation. Like, you, if when Fabulous got made off of Clue tapes.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
people,
yeah.
Other places may now know him for other stuff, but he got made off the Clue tape.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Starting, yeah. the first person, the first voice you heard was Fabulous Sport.
Mm-hmm. No, definitely DJ Clue's you know, real Ivy League MC institution.
I feel like those are the foundations that made me, like, the listenability, hearing songs, knowing what I could do, what I could try, what I could go for. Then it was like, you know, people in the, you know, local community, like, you know what I'm saying, like Touch, like even Akinelli, like those guys gave me game when I was coming up. On how to write songs, write better songs, make better tracks, make better, you know what I'm saying, overall listenable shit. And I use that shit every day. Billy Bop, this guy, he was actually in the BTS, Motown, some real shit, like historical shit. This nigga told me everything about producing back when I was like 16. Mm-hmm. And I just took that information and I used that shit as my foundation. You know what I'm saying? To this day, I make all my shit in my crib. I make other people shit too, but you know what I'm saying, like, I make all my shit, and I'm happy to keep doing it like that the rest of my life. It's a labor of love. You know what I'm saying? Like, certain things you don't know you could do till you do it, and the confidence that you get from it, that shit is fucking fly, man. It makes you stronger. It makes you believe in yourself. So I literally love to learn new shit, love to try new shit, love to do new shit, because you never know. That shit might be the thing that help you. Might be the thing that catapult you to believe in yourself in a whole different way.
Now, off camera, you know, you spoke, you know, highly of Noriega for proponent Noriega.
Oh, man. I wish I could tell this nigga, but I'm going to tell him. Like, Nori was my first favorite rapper. And I don't know if favorite rapper is the right word, but I used him as a measuring stick. Like, Nori was real. He said shit that was, like, fitting. It was culturally responsible, and like it was pushing the mentality of artists. Like, this cookie cutter mentality, this, oh, I'm not gutter, or I'm not, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of rappers have to come together as a package. Like, package, like, everything package, your image and the... And Nori kind of, like, fumbled his way through a solo career because Capone was locked up. And I loved that shit. I loved everything about it. I loved NRE, Nori, Stand for Niggas on the Run. Like, I loved all that shit. Clue championed that shit because they from Queens. And Clue let me hear all that shit ahead of time. Like, the songs he did on the Streets is Watching soundtrack, songs he did, like, I'm Leaving, like, those, Nori, I'll tell you, Nori was one of my first favorite rappers. And I used him as a measuring stick, and I was like, if I could be as tight as Nori, I'm on my way. And it didn't take long for me to get as tight as Nori and shit, but it was like, it was so important for me to get on that level, to get on the level where, yo, Nori know this, Nori know that, Nori know that. It's already bucked that. I rap to make you famous. Like, those verses, those deliveries, those styles, it created the shit that I fuck around with. You know what I'm saying? When I say some wild shit, like, if your ass ain't fat and your titties ain't a handful, bitch, you gonna get canceled. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's a Nori line. That's a Nori would have said that. Like.
Now, I wanted to ask, you know, as far as, like, you know, now I've listened to, you know, your last few albums, you know, Sold Out Show, that was a great body of work. It was different because, you know, the production wasn't, you could tell, like, the
typical.
It wasn't like a necessarily like hip hop influence.
It was
more
over.
So like a, it was like a collaboration of, I don't necessarily want to say like alternative music. It had a different vibe.
Even the drums, I think about it when I hear it, because like a lot of the drums is not rap drums. It's like kind of rock and roll drums. Like, a lot of rock and roll drums in it. But like the people I work with two dudes specifically, Isaac, I Win, his name is Rev Win. You can look him up, he makes a whole bunch of stuff. And another dude named Gerald Slevin, and he's like a super talented one man band. This guy engineers, writes, produces, creates all type of amazing soundscapes. Like, but those two guys, if I tell you about Sold Out, like, I made Sold Out and I had writer's block the whole time. The whole time. I felt so much pressure because I was making my first album, all original. I had these two dudes who I didn't know that well, and I wanted to impress them and show them, like, yo, this is how good my shit is. So I felt like a lot of pressure every time I went there, every time I recorded. And the shit that came out of it, it's so fly. And that's why I love it so much. Yeah. Because the shit that came out of it, like songs like Done, songs like Player, songs like Chicken, Anytime, those shits is, they gonna stand the test of time. You know what I'm saying? Like, first, like, everybody can say they do shit. You know what I'm saying? A lot of dudes sample songs, a lot of dudes cover records, a lot of dudes interpolate shit. When I do one, it's never been done before. You know what I'm saying? When I did Player, ain't nobody ever used the Soul Glow from Coming to America. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's my shit. That shit been used 7 different times after, but nobody did it before me. I'm the first person to use the new shoes, I Can't Wait, in a sample in 2009. That shit been sampled 5-6 times after that. Like, I look up these things before I do the shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you a buyer, just say that. You know what I'm saying? If I'm a trendsetter, just remember that. I'm a trendsetter, these niggas are trying to remember us. So you can pull me anytime you get your chat out. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's how I look at this shit. I don't follow nobody. I'm ahead of niggas. I'm from the future. I am from the future. I gotta be. Cause I make some shit, and then 2-3 years, now niggas come with it. I made a song called Chicken in 2014 on that, Sold Out. Nobody wasn't calling Money Chicken. It was uptown niggas that actually said that shit in real talk. They were in real time. That's how they referred to the money they was making. They called it Chicken. Nobody didn't put it in the song. Then Cardi B, whenever that fuck was, 2018, comes with the next song, like, oh, Chicken, Chicken. Like, that shit is all me.